My name is Mary Ann Mishaw. I live at 3411 Washington Street, Rivers Row, apartment 306. We are objecting to the changing of the zoning for family units, mainly because of loss of our safety. Many of our residents walk along the property between our units for exercise. They use walkers, they use canes. Some of us, myself included, aren't the best stable. And we know that there will be more traffic and we fear for our safety. We also fear the loss of wildlife and of our peace and quiet. And we are all objecting it. We sent this petition in, and I'm hoping some of my other cohorts will speak. Thank you.
Mike Hittner, 981st Avenue South. This is a great civic lesson here, ladies and gentlemen. This is senior citizens coming out to protect what they consider an affront to their interests, and I think that's a great lesson for all of us to learn. I would just ask, Mr. Chairman, that I agree, of course, with these folks here, but I would ask that you have a roll call vote on the vote from the commissioner.
Thank you. Other requests to speak? Or request any proceeds?
My name is Karen Steiner, and I live at 3411 Washington Street, apartment 102. We have been very concerned about this since we just found out about it here a couple weeks ago. I would like to know about that pond. What are you going to do about protecting the area? I understand that this pond is not going to have a fence around it. And we're also concerned about the bugs and the mosquitoes that are going to be there. And if there's going to be children around at these multi-family apartments, I'd like to know how safe that's going to be for the children that are going to be living there. And who is going to be liable for that? Also, we're going to lose our serenity of the area and the quietness, and that's the reason why we moved in there. There must be another location because we feel that this is really an invasion on our homes as we live there. Thank you.
My name is Jamie Bumkowski. I live on 3731 Washington Street. I have a private home there. I'm not in the senior units. I own the property that would be bordering this. We've had a company farther down move in earlier, a couple years ago, and we've had people on our property on a regular basis. It's private property. And I'm concerned about somebody getting hurt on my property. I'm concerned about of the quietness. I've never, the senior center next to me has been great. I've never had any problem. And this is a really big problem for me right now, is I just lost my husband. So I'm by myself there. And I can't have people on the property that I can't watch at all.
Thank you. Thank you. Do you need to, ma'am, can you say your name again just one more time for Joe, for the record?
Jamie Bumkowski.
Other individuals wishing to speak in the public hearing. Call for the second time. Is there anyone else wishing to speak? Scott?
I'm Scott Kellogg. I live at 511 Elm Street. And I'm speaking on behalf of the project. When you look at the median income in Wisconsin Rapids, it's $38,322. And compared to DeWitt County, overall is $51,603. And we need affordable housing for the community of Wisconsin Rapids. And any project you come up with, you're gonna find people showing up and sharing their concern. And they have a legitimate concern. But any project can be made conditional. And listening to the concerns they have, conditional initiatives can be made with the developer, hopefully to remedy any concerns that they have. The Wisconsin Rapids Housing Study in 2016, 32% of the residents stated they know someone who is struggling with housing costs and may be in danger of becoming homeless. And Encourage Community Study in 2017, 49% of the residents said because of access to quality, affordable housing is a very important priority in the future of the community. An additional 38% of the residents said it was somewhat important. Encourage Community Study, also in 2017, 45% of the residents said increased access to affordable housing is a very important priority for the future of the community. An additional 42% of the residents said it was somewhat important. You can't attract businesses if you don't have locations and affordable housing for their employees. And you found that out with the presentation that was earlier. You're not gonna have businesses come to Wisconsin Rapids if there's not affordable housing. Wisconsin Rapids study, need for more quality and affordable housing options for both owners and renters. And the research with regard to health, I was working with the health department and a group from the health department. Affordable quality housing, as a result of that, the individuals have more resources for needs such as healthcare, health food, and transportation, and also increase financial security and safety and decrease of stress. And it's important for a healthy community. Most appropriate, so this is, I think, the most appropriate location when you look at the housing in that area. There's a number of multi-family housing and it's has neighbors right in that area. So it's not popped in to one just residential area. It promotes economical development, and employees will work in Wisconsin Rapids and spend money in Wisconsin Rapids. I know many individuals work in Wisconsin Rapids, live in Clover, and spend the money in Clover. If this development is not approved, then what development would be approved and where? And if this development is not approved now, then when will you approve a development? Any questions?
Anyone else wishing to address the body here tonight? For the record. And for the third and final time, anyone wishing to address the body? Close the public hearing.